just trying to get paid. Been hotter than 100 suns. I can't find no shade. Just two more rows and I'm good to go. Yeah, I'm shutting this tractor down. Give me a half an hour for a shave and a shower, and I'll be outside your house. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but I'm taking you uptown tonight. Might have a little mud on my wheels, but they gonna shine with you up inside. Gonna hit the club, gonna cut a rug, burn it up like neon lights. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but we're gonna dance the dust right off them tonight.
Bam, off to deer camp. You awake, Blake?
A little bit.
A little bit. You ready to shoot a big one? Mm-hmm. Mom? Mm-hmm. You ready to shoot a big one?
Huge
one.
Huge.
Oh, gotta go big.
Huge.
Okay.
Or just one.
Yeah.
I'll take one.
Excellent.
Here's our deer camp 2018. Nice Airbnb we rented for $500 a week. Blake, what do you think?
Amazing.
Yeah? This place is pretty epic. Let's go get the gun stands ready. Check the cameras. See what's cruising and moving.
Cruising and moving.
All right, all the bow stands are down.
One more to go.
Get the carpets in the gun stand. Get ready to rock. It's gonna be epic tomorrow. Talking 3 inches of snow.
Rolling out of here in like 20 minutes. You ready, Blake?
Oh yeah.
3 inches of snow. 5 hours of sleep?
Not enough.
Not enough, no. There was a camo explosion in this bedroom. Someone threw a hand grenade in an orange tub. Was it you, Kelly?
No.
Well, it's opening day of the Wisconsin gun season. It's around 7 o'clock, and Tyler and Jason are watching the farm back home while we're hunting our farm in Vernon County, and Tyler texted me and his wife put the smack down on a big one and said it's outside the ears. They lost sight of it though. It was like a 50-yard shot and went around him in the pine trees, but he never saw it come out, so hopefully that buck's down. We haven't seen anything here yet, but we got in and it's so quiet. It's like 5 mile an hour wind, and I feel like we made a lot of noise getting in, but that's just how it goes sometimes. But there could be some coming from behind us. You know what I mean? There could have been more deer than just the three.
It's been a slow, slow morning, huh, Blake? 4 does all morning. It's 11 o'clock. We're gonna head back to the truck, warm up a little bit, eat our lunch and some heat. Come back out and hopefully Blake can put a big one down, right? You and your Creedmoor. See what we can do tonight. Check out our view we got. It's pretty nice up here. Ready to eat some lunch?
Yes, I'm freezing.
Right.
And I kind of ate almost my entire lunch already.
What?
I got snacky.
Nothing like a cold peanut butter and jelly to warm you up.
Right? Like the peanut butter is like a peanut butter ice.
Yep.
Sheet.
It says it's 32. It doesn't feel like it.
No, my feet got real cold.
Just a little bit. They were just starting to get cold when I decided to walk out.
Lunch break's over. We're back in the stand. Looking for deer and doing homework.
Second morning. 9 degrees out. No wind. Hopefully we can get it done today, huh, buddy? Yep. Well, it's the second day of gun season here in Wisconsin. And I put Blake in his blind this morning. And sat with him till about 9:30 and came over to my blind. So I'm finally in my blind and it's Blake's first solo sit by himself with a gun. So he knows what he's doing. He should be okay. I told him anything 200 and under, go ahead and shoot it. So he knows where his range marks are, what landmarks. So he should be good. So he's way to my southwest and Kelly is back hard to my northwest, so we kind of have a triangle of death here. So if anything comes out, we're all shooting about 500 yards in between us. So basically 250 is kind of a middle mark where we're at, so we should be sitting good. We've got basically almost the whole 75 acres covered from this triangle of death, every direction we can shoot. So we should be good. If anything decides to get up out of the bedding, move around, we'll see it.
There's the mighty hunter. Big 12-year-old on his first solo sit. Heading in for lunch break.
What a slow, miserable day. There's like 40 minutes left in the second day of gun season. I haven't seen a deer all day. The wind's been beating me up. It's cold. It was 8 degrees this morning. I don't even know what it is right now, but it's cold. Oh well, that's hunting. We're gonna get down after we're done here and then go over and see Sarah's buck. The thing is a giant. It's gotta be between 190 and 205. It's just huge. So we're gonna go check that out and then go home and warm up.
That thing is a toad.
It's like not even real.
It didn't, for me, it didn't sink in right away. It wasn't until after we got back here, we stopped at the neighbors, we came back home, then I'm washing my face in the bathroom, and I just walk out, and I look at Byron, and I'm just bawling. He's like, what are like so many feels? I can't even right now.
Sarah, this thing is unbelievable. Is that 14 scoreable points then, or 13?
Last night we counted 13. Today we counted 14. Yeah, so it's questionable.
I was gonna say that.
It's just if you can count that, if those count, I think
they're close. We're gonna farmer count them and say it's 14. That thing is awesome. That's got to be 190. If the sheds were 187 last year, I mean he's got to be in the 190s.
And I have pictures of him too to compare how much bigger he grew.
Yep. Yeah, he might surprise you and even be 200. The mass on that thing that thing's carrying, plus his beam length. I mean, those got to be 22 or 24 inch main beams.
It's Monday morning of gun season, so it'd be the third day here in Wisconsin. Still really slow on our farm. We had such bad floods this fall, and it pushed all of our deer off this farm, but we had, I don't know, 4 to 6 resident does that usually are on our farm here, and they're not here right now, so we're not even seeing those. We've had snow for the last 3 days, and I kind of think that either put them in panic mode and pushed them over into the food. Across the road, there's about a 100-acre cornfield standing right across the street, and we have absolutely no food on our side. We have all the cover and all the water they want. We have no food. The flood basically drowned out all of our plots, so we're gambling that something's going to chase a doe in here or something, or the locals will be driving deer and bump something in. But right now it's very bleak, very bleak.
Where's it at, brown trout? Is it down?
Going down or what?
I never saw it, so I don't know where it came from or what was going on.
Gotcha. He came from right between me and the truck and was running full force through the field. Went like he was going to go towards the broken tree and then cut right. And that's when I saw him, and it was like right midsection of the whip. The mid-whip and the trail that cuts through, and I shot.
Was he standing when he shot, or was he moving? Well, it's about 11:30. Kelly just ripped that one, and she rolled him over at like 200 yards. He was on a good sprint. And so she said it looks like a pretty good buck, so she went down to go see after about 20 minutes, and the buck was walking through the grass, and she went to shoot him and didn't reload her gun after she climbed out of her tower stand. So right now that buck is laying out in the triangle of death somewhere, and we're gonna eat lunch and let him lay down and hopefully recover him in about an hour. We'll see.
Raven, we're on the move.
Ten four. Okay, sounds good. Just take the sneak up that trail where you saw him cut in, and then try to go where the last spot you saw him was. But you might have to track him just in case.
Will do.
I think he's down.
Thank you.
He must have doubled back behind you guys and went through the food plot or something.
Yeah, I bet he stood here the whole time while I was here. And then I just started walking back and I heard him get up like Byron.
Did you shoot, or was it Byron?
Byron.
I cranked one through him running through the grass, and then I don't know who put him down. I saw him drop. Ghost, you got a copy?
Copy.
All right. I'll come get you at the four-wheeler, okay, Ghost? You hang out for a little bit. Well, it looks like Kelly's buck's down. Her and Sarah went in looking for it, and it got up and doubled around him in the tall grass, but that stuff's over my head, so she heard it come out, and Byron was in Kelly's gun stand covering that. So him and I kind of triangulated on him, and he shot like three times, and I shot once, and I saw him stop and tip over, so I don't know who got him, but it doesn't matter. Kelly's buck is down, and that's all that matters. Oh, it's a broken tine 10, isn't it?
Huh?
Is it the broken tine 10?
Yeah.
Oh, sick. That is awesome. I was really hoping it was that buck, too.
Were you?
Yeah.
I didn't care what it was. I was excited.
That is sweet.
Hit him in the rump roast.
Did you?
Yeah.
That's a long poke for you on the run.
I didn't hit him by about that much, and then that's where it came out.
Really?
So that's why he was having a hard time. Holy cow, that was crazy.
All of a sudden,
it was right next to her.
Flying.
Was it?
He was just
so
laying
told
there.
Me to go back and look?
Yeah, I'm like, you better go where you saw him lay down.
I went back and he saw him. He, like, after we walked by, he popped up and started sneaking back. Like he was going to come back out.
Like crawling, running along the ground.
Like doubling around you.
And I'm like, good thing I stayed because he's going right back home, you know?
Yep. So you were in the tower too? Yep, that was perfect.
And then I was just like, I heard him get up and I was like, Byron!
And when I saw him going for that woods, I'm like, one last shot, he's moving.
Yeah.
Jesus. Thank God.
You ripped two at him, and I ripped one at him.
Yeah.
And then he stopped, and all of a sudden I saw him buckle to the scope and drop, and then I heard that. Like, oh, he got him. Thank God.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that is sweet.
I can't believe he was just laying in there, watching them walk by.
Yep.
Because they circled right around him. Then they talked. Then you must have talked to her. And I'm like, dang it, I wish I could tell. And then she started circling back, and he snuck up on us.
Where was he laying?
Right in these weeds.
Like, probably 5 feet off of the path.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Like, right here?
What an infield footprint.
So where do you think you hit him the first round?
You can see it on the other side.
Through that, like, through the butt, not through the guts?
Yeah. The rump roast.
That's what I figured, because I'm like, when you shot and he disappeared on the run, I'm like, you had to hit him somewhere good.
Yeah. Well, and go figure, like, I mean, he's running.
Did it look like he was running pretty healthy or no?
Yeah.
Really?
I mean, he was moving, but I said, uh-oh.
I had him in the scope, and all I could see was, like, the upper...
She left. I'm not letting that deer get out of here.
Excellent.
I know I saw it lay down, and I set the gun down, got the binocs. I could see the horns laying over there. I'm like, that's a pretty nice buck.
Yeah. Well, that's why I asked her. I was like, which one do you think it is? And she's like, I don't know. It was nice. I was shooting. I was really hoping it was him because he was out here all the time.
Anything more than a four-pointer was
going to go down today. After not seeing anything, I was like, there's deer running. It's going to happen.
Good job, honey.
I'm so pumped. I'm so pumped everyone was here for it.
Yeah. Good experience.
Yeah. We got to get Blake.
Yeah, he's probably just like eating peanut butter and jelly up there wondering what's going
on. Oh, he was. When I called him last time, he's like, I'm just going to eat my Oreos.
I looked at him. You could just see his head. It looked like it was resting on the window. I'm like, I don't see any orange. I'm looking. All of a sudden, you just see his head. Like, that's hilarious. Yeah. At least the deer don't see you.
Yeah. No, he likes to stay down and hidden. He just like buckles over in his seat and just has his head sticking up.
Yep. Make sure you're on the right angle to see every point.
Yeah, especially since we're missing something. Right?
Gotta have the super bun in the picture.
Oh, show.
The only deer we saw for a day and a half.
That's what I said, we gotta get this one.
Thank goodness. I would've been pissed if I would've missed it. Like,
this was his core area. What's your code?
It's so way pushy.
What's your code? Your phone's locked. Camera, there we go. Don't blink.
I try not to in my contacts.
Dang it, you did it again. Okay. Every time I take one, you blink. Okay, turn them towards me a little bit.
Well, there's some like this?
Oh,
okay. Like this.
There you go.
Yeah.
It's Monday night. It's the third day of gun season. And Kelly shot a nice 10-pointer this afternoon. We got that buck down with a little help of our friends, Byron and Sarah. So our farm is kind of buggered up right now. And Byron's been seeing a lot of bucks over here on his farm, so he invited us to come over and see if Blake can take a buck off his farm. So Blake's pretty pumped. A lot of nice 8-pointers over here, one great big 10, and a couple other little nice bucks. So hopefully when we'll step out, we got about an hour and a half yet, and maybe Blake will get a shot opportunity to put one on the ground, huh?
Yeah.
Yep. All right. Deer of the set. Get ready. Thank you.
us because he heard me grunting. Go ahead and get ready. Which way is he going? To the right or left? Can you see him?
Oh, he's running.
Put your safety on. There you go. Dude, there was a ton of bark when flying. I wonder if you hit a branch. Did you see it? There he is, stuck one.
Keep going that way.
Where's that?
Okay. Here's some. Isn't it?
Yeah. Ooh, that's a fresh drop.
Well, Blake shot his buck. We watched the footage back, and I thought he hit him decent, and turned out it looked like he hit him low through the brisket and blew out the opposite leg on the other side. So we tracked him tonight for like 300 yards, and we're going to leave him lay overnight and do a little morning sit, and then go on him late morning, maybe 8:30, 9 o'clock, see if we can find him then. We were definitely pushing him. We found some wet blood, and doesn't look like an artery. It's probably just a low hit with a muscle break and a bone break, but we'll see. We'll go on tomorrow. We're going to surround where he is. It's in a big valley, and then if he comes hobbling out, we'll be able to put him down. So,
go on the track, the big fork and spoon. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning. We don't lay all night, and hopefully he's in there and he's stiff. Hopefully he's down, or either we get another round in him quick and recover him, right? Right.
There's a few patches where you could tell he stood and it dripped. Yeah, at the end it just got pin drops.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be hard to find him. I don't know if we're going to. I mean, I know the muscle was shot out because I could see it through the binos last night when he was going around that corner, but
taking down camp. Tuesday afternoon, we looked for Blake's buck most of the morning. Lost blood, couldn't find him anywhere. So, we opted to come back, bus camp down apart, get all packed up, and then head back and hunt on my buddy's farm tonight for our last sit. And then hopefully get out early in the morning and head to the hospital around noon.
Well, it's the fourth day of the gun season here in Wisconsin. In the same stand last night where Blake shot that little buck last night. We were unable to find him. We watched the footage back a bunch of times, and he actually hit him through the brisket and into that opposite leg. He hit him low, but he hit the tree. Last night we backed out and looked pretty hard today, and no luck. So we're back in the same stand tonight. We're hoping that he comes back through.
Well, I came back in the stand and tried to get fork and spoon. It's pretty cold out and nothing really moved, so it's time to pack up.
Well, so ends our adventure up here.
That's it. One buck.
One buck down.
What do you think, Blaker? You want to come up next weekend with me?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Get some sweet revenge.
Yeah.
Excellent. We'll have to clean this place up, pack up, hit the road in the morning. Day before Thanksgiving.
Happy Givens.
Let's go home. Hotel motel life, second weekend. Blake, you ready to kill a buck?
Mm-hmm.
Me too. Let's go knock a couple down. Be home by Sunday, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It's November 23rd. There's only a couple days left of the Wisconsin 9-day gun season. I'm back here in the spot where I had a ladder stand for the rut. I'm on the edge of the jungle back here where it's real thick and it opens up into open timber and then it goes east towards a big patch of bedding area. So I'm hoping that it's a south-southeast wind this afternoon all night and it's supposed to rain around 5:30. So I'm hoping these deer are gonna come out of this jungle and then come around behind me and kind of work towards the cornfield that's back towards the north. So my wind is really good, but they're gonna have to travel with the wind to go to the corn, which I'm pretty sure they're gonna do because there's not much food left around here. But should be good. It's gonna be a danger close mission if one comes out. I mean, you can only shoot maybe 60 yards, but 270 should put them on the ground. Hopefully it works.
Saturday morning, close explosion, motel hotel life.
It's Saturday morning out here. Tomorrow's the last day of the night. 9-day gun season. And there's like absolutely no wind. It's a southwest wind, so it's a bad wind for me over here, but it's good for Kelly and Junior, so maybe they'll smell me and kind of shuffle their way through the bedding and the tall cover, but we'll see. It's supposed to switch around 9 o'clock out of the dead west, so it'll be good for all of us then, but the southwest wind's gonna kill me right now. But you never know. One might be out of my wind current and come into the wind too, and I'll get a shot at him, we'll see. Well, it's Saturday afternoon. It's pretty calm back here. Maybe 3 or 4 mile an hour wind. It's pretty quiet. We have one more day left. This is probably our last night set out here until we get home into the metro zone, so.
Deer season in the books.
Yep.
Kelly was the only one to drop a buck. It was slow.
Only one taxidermy bill.
Yep. Now we get to go down and hunt the metro unit. Get another 9 days out of it. Right, Blake?
Yep.
Maybe you get a buck at the farm?
I hope so.
I hope so too. On to the farm.
Yes, indeed.